You'll move the pages. Pages niche
jana. I'll do that. I'll do that. You just like indicate me. I'll do that.
Yes, okay, as Tanda sir has already shared a link with you regarding the online form which you have to fill for the examination. So the first requirement, like previously it was like you used to require the eligibility number, but for the newcomers, for the freshers, actually eligibility number is not required. Okay, that is the first information. So you can go ahead and create your profiles. Those who already have profiles can delete the previous data and continue with that. Then check whether whatever courses you have done, which, I've got some information like the subject like BE is not visible right now. Just don't panic. Okay, it might take some time. The 15th is the last day without BE. Okay, so have patience. Any doubts you have, you can contact Datta sir or you can also contact me directly. Okay? We'll discuss today what is the syllabus, first of all, what are the different subjects which you're supposed to select by filling the form, okay, especially the ones which are electives, okay, because the timetable is not ready yet, so the subjects are already been provided to me by the HOD, Vikasa is already giving me the list, so I'll call out the names also of the subjects, please note it down first, and then we'll look at the syllabus, how it is, and then we'll also discuss how the credits are divided. Now from the regular courses from 101 to 106 are your generic core subjects. which are of 100 marks. Okay, so 50% will be evaluated by the institute, okay, and 50% by the university. Now, the pattern of the exams, as of now, it is offline, that is, you have to write papers. Okay, but if there are any instructions from the university, we'll let you know, because last year it was all about MCQs. Okay, so might be you have to give written exam, but we are waiting for the proper instructions from the university. From the university level subjects, that is your subject number, course number 107, which is management fundamentals. Okay, for this, so you have 50 marks. Only university level assessment. No internal assessment will be conducted. Then 109, which is entrepreneurship development, ED. Again, 50 marks, total internal. And the last one is 111, which is your lab, that is legal aspects of business. For these three subjects, yeah, I'll repeat that, 107, that is management fundamental, that is the first subject. Second one is 109, which is entrepreneurship development, ED. And the last one, the third one, is your lab, that is your legal aspects of business. Okay, so we are supposed to select this thing. Now from the internal subjects which will be evaluated by the institute only, no external evaluation will be there. Okay, note down the three subjects. The first one is 113, which is verbal communication lab, LAB. Next one is 115, which is selling and negotiation skills lab. And the last one, 116, which is MS Excel. Okay, MS Excel, the third one. Now, other than this, you'll find that there are some other subjects like cyber security, okay, or even human rights. Then there's one more, which is about the Constitution of India, okay, which is mandatory. That will be automatically selected. All these three subjects will be basically for grades. Okay, so we will be conducting some workshops, and we'll have some sort of assessment also done on the three subjects. Okay, basically this will be out of 25 marks. Okay, one credit score. Okay, and MCQs or might be some basic one-line questions would be there, and it will be evaluated on the same thing. Okay, that schedule will be given to you later on. Okay. I hope the doubts about the subjects which you are going to opt is clear. While filling the form, if you have any technical issues, as I said, you can contact either me or the person. Okay? Now, coming to the assessment which actually is carried out at the institute level. Okay, as I said, there are three sections. The first section, which is your core subjects, which are conducted, where we have 50 marks which is evaluated by the institute and 50 by the university. Okay, now the 50 marks which will be evaluated will be a concurrent evaluation. That means the subject teacher will schedule the detailed evaluation, okay, along with the date when he is going to conduct those evaluations, and that will be provided to you. Now it might be during his session, okay, or on the follow the deadlines, right? Because if you do not give those assessments, no reminders will be given to you. Please remember, okay, those, especially those who have any other issues, please take prior permission from the director and the concerned faculty. Okay, Only then, if he's allowing you, then you can remain absent for that particular test or assessment. He will arrange for some other assessment later on. Okay. Now, there are different methods in which assessment can be done. Okay. Basically, if you look at the syllabus, now when we are talking about the first generic or the first one, it is carrying 3 credits. 3 credits, around 100 marks. Okay. As I said, you can see here also, you can refer to the website. On our institute website under MBA program, we have uploaded the syllabus. So you can download that syllabus and you can go through that as well. Clear? I'll just give you some brief information which is important right now. Now you can see there we have UL, which is generic elective UL, that is university level. Okay, university level, which the 3 subjects which I told you to select, this is totally assessed by the university. And the remaining, the other one, which is totally internal, that will be only for 50 marks, 2 credits. Okay. Now, how many assessments will be done? Totally depends on the faculty. Okay. But there are some minimum requirements. There are some minimum requirements which will be followed by each of them. Okay. So, if we can go to page number 11 now.
We are on 11.
That number will be different than this number. Okay, I'll just tell you what the information is. Now, whenever we have 3 credits course, okay, so especially the one where it is 100 marks assessment, is minimum 3 assessments will be done. Okay, minimum 3 assessments will be done by the faculty where we have 100 marks assessment total. That is 50 internal and 50 external. So internal faculty will have 3 assessments minimum. If they decide to take more, it's up to them. Yeah. Then for 2 credits course, minimum 2 assessments will be done. 2 assessments. Again, it's up to the faculty. And for 1 credit score, there'll be only 1 assessment. This is the minimum requirement I'm telling you. Okay. The faculty is free to go ahead with multiple assessments. 1 single assessment would be minimum of 25 marks, not less than that. Okay, that is the instructions given by the university. So as per the syllabus, minimum 25 marks assessment has to be done for 1 assessment. Later on, when we have to, let's say one faculty takes 4 assessments, 25 marks each, so that will be 100 marks. The faculty will decide whether they want to go for average marks or they can select best of 2. Okay, they have option, right? Now, I think we have been going for average marks. Okay, depending on the total number of assessment, total marks, we usually find the average, convert that into the 50, and those marks are sent. Okay, before sending the marks are displayed for the students. Okay, if you have any queries, any questions, or you want to go for improvement, you can approach the faculties. Okay, but that is depending on the faculty whether he'll allow you. Depending on the time period which is left, they will decide on that their own. Okay, it is not mandatory. Plus, if you feel you really need to improve on your marks, you can also approach the director, take his permission, and then approach the faculties as well. Clear? Fine. Now, passing percentage, you already know it is 40%. So if it is out of 50, 20 marks minimum is passing percentage. Overall is also 40. Clear? That is the concept of scale down. Remember this, this is a very important concept. Because usually what happens in internal, if suppose you are scoring 50 out of 50, okay, and in external you do not perform that. If there is a difference of 25% between the 2 marks, then the university is going to scale it down depending your external performance. So if your external performance is not up to the mark, please remember the marks will be scaled down. That happens in, I think, other courses as well. Yeah. So you cannot argue that I had got 40 or I got 50 out of 50, how come the marks were reduced? Because the marks will be displayed on the notice board, you have to note it up. Okay. and copy of faculties whenever there is an issue. See that you follow all the deadlines. Okay, because if you do not follow the deadlines, what is going to happen? Let us see, you have been given 10 days more to complete the assignment. Okay, but the faculty is free to convert that 25 marks. Instead of that, we might assess out of 20 or 15. So you are going to lose on marks. Okay, so follow the deadlines properly. That's my instruction. My and all the other things as well. Okay, now talking about the different types of assessments. We have around from group A to group F. So if you look at the syllabus also, if you can go to the syllabus where we have group A to F, just check it out. I think it is comprehensive content evaluation methods. If you go down, yeah, this one. Now come to group A. Okay, now if you look at this groups which are available, okay, in many cases, like for the first one, it is written into bracket, not more than, you can see that individual assessment, not more than one per this particular course. Okay, so out of this, the faculty is free to take one out. It is not minimum. You might not do something else. Okay, but look at group B. Look at group B then. We have at least one per course. That is from this group. Yes, no. From this group, as number case study, case study, situation analysis, and presentation, he will definitely go for one of them. He will definitely go for one of them. Okay, and the remaining two, if it is from any of the groups, plus the groups given or the options given in the syllabus, he is free to decide his own way of assessment as well. Okay. We used to be like last time, like one I remember when Jamshed sir had given a video for analysis. Okay, and after watching the video, we are supposed to give a presentation, record yourself and upload that video. Okay, so it was something which is not given in the syllabus. So faculties are also free to design their own way of conducting the assessment as well. Clear? Now, while giving it concurrent evaluation or assessment, whatever questions or might be a written assignment or case studies, the faculties will provide you a rubric. The rubric will tell you how the marking scheme would be. Okay, if you are scoring, say, full marks, on what basis you are going to get the marks, that will be clearly mentioned in the assessment given to you. So wherever you have any doubts, you can approach the faculty. Okay, discuss where you have made mistakes and consult. Because ultimately it is about improvement. It's not about, hey, this is my final marks. If you can improve based on what you have scored, that is going to help you in your final assessment. That is your external assessment. Yeah. So be free to ask questions to the faculties on the areas where you can improve on. Okay. Now you can go through all of this. You can refer, it's a very big document of 273 pages. It talks about your COs, POs, the program objective, the course objective, the linking between the course objective and the program objective as well. Okay. Usually, as per that, the directions given or the instructions given to us by the director, we are supposed to prepare session plans as well. Okay. So each session, what are the topics we are going to cover? So if the syllabus tells, for example, for like the first subject, if there are 40 sessions which are planned, so in 40 sessions, what are the different topics that will be covered? That will be given to you. Okay, that will be a part that will be discussed by the faculty in the class. Okay, so you can note down that as well. Clear? All the final marks, as I'm repeating this again, because all the final marks of all the students would be displayed. So we maintain kind of complete transparency in giving the marks as well and showing it on the notice board. Clear? No partiality as on now has been reported, or no complaints have been received from any of the students till now. Whatever issues you have, consult faculty. If it is not resolved, the information that I'm there, the vessel is there, you can talk to them. He is very supportive. Any doubts you have regarding the assessment? Any questions?
Reference books, sir.
Reference books. Now, if you look at the syllabus also, you can go to one of the subjects. Any one subject, you can, if you look at the subject syllabus given to you, usually there are 5 units. Okay, you'll find 5 units there. Okay, each unit, like when I'm teaching decision science, okay, so each unit have different subtopics in it. Okay, you are not going to get all the study material in one book. There are multiple reference books, websites given to you, okay, even textbooks are mentioned, which are available in the library. So feel free to approach the library whenever you want to issue the books. First of all, I request everyone to, yeah. So here you can see this is one of the syllabus you can see here. And the course outcomes are mentioned and what is expected. Okay, if I and I have to complete one particular course objective, what is the definition of that is given to you. Okay, you can refer to that. Ultimately, what happens is at the end of the semester, the faculties are supposed to come up with the attainment level. If I decide for my subject, 65 marks is my attainment level. So I need to calculate or I need to find out how many students crossed that level of 65%. Now, might be some subjects are very difficult. So I might take the percentage down. Let us say 55. Okay. Or some subjects are practical oriented, like advanced Excel. It's totally practical oriented. You're not going to sit and write notes on that. Okay, you're going to actually perform it practically. So for such type of subjects, we give small projects or small practical assignments. Fine. And once we get the result, usually you'll find that many of you, I do, you know, request you all to convey or discuss among yourself, especially in subjects where things have to be discussed, right? Like Excel. If you are not good at Excel, you can discuss with your friends and come up with your own ideas. But ultimately, what happens? I'm not going to judge you by the way you have done the assignment, but what new thing you have introduced in that particular assignment. So your marks might vary. Usually I have found that many of them copy the files. But I get to know the files you've been copying, because if you go to the properties of the file, you get to know the authors as well. Okay, so don't copy it. You can take it. Because ultimately the purpose is learning. If you're able to learn from each other, good. Clear? Now, going down to the syllabus, you'll find that reference books are mentioned there. Plus, some suggested, you can see textbooks are also mentioned. Okay, the faculties for that particular subject will tell you which book they are referring and also refer to. Yeah. For additional learning, reference books are recommended. Even websites, YouTube channels are there. You can visit YouTube. There are lots of videos available. You can make use of those as well. Okay. And totally, as I'm not expert in all the other subjects, the subject teacher will guide you regarding that. Clear? Any other? Any question? One more thing is mentioned as per the syllabus. Minimum 75% of attendance is required for each subject, not overall. But sir has already told you, 100% attendance is required. As per the syllabus, I'm telling you, repeating again, minimum 75% is required so that we allow you to fill the examination form. Your examination form can be rejected by the director if your percentage of attendance is less than 75. Clear? Because all the records of your attendance, subject-wise, is subjected, submitted to the HOD. Later on, it is summarized and presented to the director. Right? So that is also given in the syllabus. You can refer to that once again. Right? That's all from my end. If you have any other question regarding examination, you can contact me individually as well, or you can ask me now as well.
So they have one question. Is now they are filling exam form, na? Then when they will have exams actually?
Okay.
They have a doubt about
date,
that.
I think Galassa can tell about the tentative date about the exams. the final exams. I think it's around March, April, somewhere. So I hope I'm right. So the exams tentative March 10th or April. Okay, but don't worry about that. You know, until unless you know your syllabus is over, I don't think so. The exam dates will be declared. Yes. Now, if you want to know about the electives, the major specialization and the minor specialization, I'll just give you a brief about it, because that is what you're going to select in the second semester. In the second semester, you're supposed to go for the major specialization. Okay, you can consult your placement officer. You can also consult your teachers, your faculties regarding the specializations. There are many who have doubts about which subject to select or which specialization they should go for. Now, the right person who can guide you regarding this would be the placement officer, because as sir said, you need to go for your psychometric test as well. Okay, so that will be conducted, and depending on your interest also, it's up to you which one you want to select. But before selecting your major specialization, please once again go to the syllabus, check what are the different topics there, okay, which are the different subjects offered under that particular specialization, and then select. Okay, not because a particular area is doing very well or there's huge future in that particular area, you should go for that. Okay, it's up to you as well, your liking as well. Okay, in which area you want to make your career, that also depends. Okay, now when you go to the third semester, you're supposed to either select or you either continue major only, or you also select a minor specialization. This should be a main and a minor specialization. If you can in the specialization, as you know, there are total 5 major specializations. Okay, and the new specialization which was added in 2019 is business analytics. Okay, we already have marketing, finance, HR, operations, and the fifth one is your business analytics. Okay. Now, apart from these 5 major specializations, there are some other specializations which are added, like agri is there. Okay, so there are some 5 more which are added from where you can pick up the minor specialization. They are not for the major specialization at all. That's only for minor specialization. Okay. There's another doubt, when especially when you know students go major and minor, which subject should I drop and which I should take? Okay, so as per the rule, when you go to the third semester, you're supposed to drop 2 subjects from the major specialization. One which is of university level specialization subject, okay, and one internal. And you have to pick up 1 external subject from the minor specialization and 1 internal subject from the minor specialization. So overall, number of credits remain the same. Okay. So what you are going to get from the minor specialization is 2 subjects. 1 from the university level, which is of 100 marks, 50 internal, 50 external, and 1 internal, which will be evaluated by the institute only. Now, while taking the subjects, again, I'm telling you, again, discuss with the faculties and decide your subjects. So you have an option, especially when you go for the third semester. Okay, that is how. So third semester and fourth semester, you'll have both major, minor. Now, some of you can also opt only for major. Now, those who go only for major has an option of going for dual specialization. That is what it is written in the syllabus. Okay, but those who are going for major and minor, they don't have an option of dual specialization. Clear? As per the instructions from the syllabus, I don't know how the university will take that forward, but wait for the instructions, especially those who want to do dual specialization. It's not clear yet. Right? Now, there are some additional foundation courses as well. Some enrichment courses as well, which are mentioned in the syllabus. Now, when I'm talking about foundation courses, might be your weak in particular area, Like if suppose I am taking advanced Excel, but you are not good at basic Excel, so you can take up a foundation course in Word, Excel, PowerPoint, anything. Okay, there is a list of courses given to us. Fine. Now you can also use 22 credits. I hope I'm right here.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, around 20%. Yeah. Fine. 22%, or you can say 20% of credits. You can go and do some courses on the Swayam platform, MOOC platform. Coursera, as I said, is one of the platform which we are offering. We have a tie-up with Coursera platform. Okay. And since last 2 years, there are students who are doing courses on that particular platform. Now, if you want to use that certification for your credit score, you can do that. But provided you take permission from the director beforehand. Okay. So for some particular subject, especially internal subjects, you want to do something else, which is available on these platforms. Swayam platform is the one which is recommended by everyone. Then second preference is given to the other platforms like Coursera, edX, okay, Udemy. There are many platforms. You can do the certifications. Now, whatever score you get, the certificates along with the score has to be submitted to that particular faculty. Okay. And then that score will be given to you, those marks will be sent to the university. Okay. So you are free to select some subjects from the list given, or if you have any other subjects, relevant subjects from the other platforms as well. Clear? Any other doubts? I think it's very much clear, right? And as I said, might be individually you might be having any issues. You can anytime approach me, and we can discuss about them. If the faculties have anything to say or share, can. Now, for summer internship, as soon as you complete your first year, in the third semester, you have summer internship. Okay. Now, the placement officer, your Ravindra sir, is going to help you for that as well. So you can approach him. Now, for summer internship, we have again 3 credits, 100 marks. Internal vivas will be conducted, out of 50. So we have usually make a panel of different faculty members. So there are multiple panels, and we conduct viva and presentation. Okay. Similarly, what happens for the external examiner is appointed by the university. Okay. We take some dates are given to us. We make the arrangement. Basically, you'll have 2 or 4 panels, depending on the strength of the students or the number of days which are assigned to us. And you have to give a presentation. While giving the summer internship projects, you have to follow the deadlines given to you. Okay. You have to create a black bound book. Okay. Which you might have done in your graduation engineering as well. Okay. On that, you need to have the certificate from the company where you have done your internship, and one certificate from the institute as well. The guide which is allotted to you will go through the project on regular basis. It's not that you have to come on the last day and submit the project. Okay. If the guide do not sign your project, okay, you're going to get a 0. Please remember this. Follow the deadlines, consult your guides, okay, on regular basis. Whatever changes, whatever suggestions given to you, follow those as well. Okay. On the institute certificate, the HOD will sign, the internal guide will sign, and the director will sign. One place is left for the external examiner. Okay. The format of the certificate will be provided to you later on. Okay. In the third semester, you'll get that format as well. Okay. In some cases, if you're getting internship on your own, you can take some letters from the institute as well. Okay. That you are a student, bona fide student, and as per the syllabus of university and so on, the content is mentioned, you can approach the industry or the companies on your phone as well. Clear? Anything else?
No.
So anything else need to be said?
Yes, you can only take the scholarship.
So that's all from the examination department. Regarding the scholarship, you know, we have category students. Okay, some of you might have already started filling the scholarship forms. The website, Danta sir is in charge to handle all the scholarship cases. See that you get your income certificate. Those who have not got the income certificate, start applying for that or get it as soon as possible. And you can get in touch with Danta sir. He'll give you the deadlines and guidelines. Now that's your website on which you are supposed to go.
My deputy website.
So please note down this URL, the website name. Some of you might be already knowing it. It's MahaDBT. MahaIT.gov.in. You can follow this. Sir is going through the whole process. So pay attention to what steps he's taking here.
Cap through jinhone admission liya wo scholarship ke liye apply kar sakte hai. Baaki student other minority में जो रहते हैं against vacant में admission लिया वो भी apply कर सकते हैं जैन पारसी क्रिश्चियन मुस्लिम तो
सर तिकडे का म्हणजे काय सकते नाही मी करते
सोशल जस्टिस डिपार्टमेंट एससी कॅटेगरी साठी आहे त्याच्यामध्ये स्कॉलरशिप आणि फ्रीशिप दोन ऑप्शन आहेत ज्यांचे इन्कम 2,50,000 खाली आहे ते स्कॉलरशिप अप्लाय करते त्यांचं इन्कम 2,50,000 वरती आहे ते फ्रीशिपला अप्लाय करते त्याच्यानंतर ट्रायबल डेव्हलपमेंट डिपार्टमेंट एसटी कॅटेगरी साठी पण तिथे दोन ऑप्शन आहेत स्कॉलरशिप आणि फ्रीशिप त्याच्यानंतर डायरेक्टली ओबीसी एससीबीसी विजयंती त्याच्यामध्ये सर्वांनी ट्यूशन फी आणि एक्झामिनेशन फी टू ओबीसी स्टुडंट जे ओबीसी आहेत जे एस सी विजयंती आहेत ते ट्यूशन फी एक्झामिनेशन फी टू विजयंती स्टुडंट आणि एसबीसी आहेत ते ट्यूशन फी एक्झामिनेशन फी टू एसबीसी स्टुडंट आणि जे ओपन कॅटेगरी आहेत ईडब्ल्यूएस किंवा इन्कम बिलो 1,00,000 आहे कॅप थ्रू ऍडमिशन घेतलेलं आहे एससीबीसी ओबीसी एससीबीसी आणि ओपन कॅटेगरी ते डायरेक्टर ऑफ टेक्निकल एज्युकेशन टेक्निकल एज्युकेशन डायरेक्टर ऑफ टेक्निकल एज्युकेशन मध्ये राजश्री छत्रपती शाहू महाराज शिक्षण शिष्यवृत्ती योजना आणि जर हॉस्टेलचं सुरू झालं तर पंजाबराव देशमुख वसतिगृह निर्वाह भत्ता त्याला अप्लाय करू शकता मायनॉरिटी डेव्हलपमेंट डिपार्टमेंट मध्ये जे अगेन्स्ट वॅकेंट मध्ये आहेत मुस्लिम ख्रिश्चन जैन ते मायनॉरिटी स्कॉलरशिप साठी अप्लाय करू शकतात त्याच्यासाठी त्यामध्ये मायनॉरिटी डिपार्टमेंट आहे डीटीच स्कॉलरशिप फॉर स्टुडंट ऑफ मायनॉरिटी कम्युनिटी पर्सन हायर अँड प्रोफेशनल कोर्सेस डीटी लिहिलेलं आहे ना ते त्या स्कीमला अप्लाय करू शकता कोणाला काय प्रॉब्लेम असेल तर मला मेसेज करा व्हॉट्सअपला मी रिप्लाय देईल सर्वांना आणि एक्झामिनेशन फॉर्म पण सुरू झालेले आहेत एक्झामिनेशनला जे होम युनिव्हर्सिटी पुणे युनिव्हर्सिटी आहे ते जुना युजर आय डी पासवर्ड युज करून फॉर्म भरू शकतात आणि त्याच्यामध्ये काय मेल आय डी किंवा मोबाईल नंबर चेंज झाला असेल तर मला कॉन्टॅक्ट करा मी तो चेंज करून देईल आणि अदर दॅन होम युनिव्हर्सिटी आहेत ते नवीन युजर आय डी क्रिएट करून फॉर्म भरू शकतात त्याच्यासाठी आधार कार्ड फोटो सिग्नेचर स्कॅन करून अपलोड करायला लागेल आणि वेबसाईट एसपीपी ग्रुपला शेअर केलेली आहे ते तुम्ही फॉलो करा आणि शेवटच्या दिवसापर्यंत वाट नका बघू फॉर्म भरायचे लास्ट दिवशी जर तुम्ही आला आणि काही टेक्निकल इश्यू असेल तर विद्यापीठात जायला लागेल, त्याच्यामुळे तुम्हाला परत गेट पे मध्ये फॉर्म भरायला लागेल, त्याच्यामुळे तुम्ही जेवढ्या लवकर होईल तेवढ्या लवकर फॉर्म भरा, कारण फर्स्ट इयर आणि सेकंड इयर सर्वांचे मिळून एकच लास्ट डेट आहे, शेवटच्या दिवशी सगळे आले तर गडबड होईल, त्याच्यामुळे फॉर्म जेवढ्या लवकर होईल तेवढ्या लवकर भरून ते चेक करून फॉर्म हे करू शकता. आणि फॉर्म मध्ये मेन आहे तुम्ही जेव्हा फॉर्म एंटर करा नाव तुमचं टाकता त्यावेळी तुम्ही जसं नाव पाहिजे पूर्ण सरनेम नेम किंवा मिडल नेम ते पूर्ण नाव टाका, जर तुम्ही अपूर्ण नाव टाकलं तर ते परत मार्कशीट वरती तसंच प्रिंट होऊन येतात आणि त्याच्यामुळे परत चेंजेस करायला लागतात, तर तेवढं फक्त केअरफुली तुम्ही पाहिजे.
Mr. Datta sir, I am just one point adding here, along with these all instructions which Mr. Datta has shared now, students who are, they are eligible for the provision which we have of the government, tuition and scholarship, we also prepare one manual for your easy records, so it is available with Mr. Datta sir only. If you have any issue regarding this, to find out whether you people are eligible to this provision or not, you contact immediately to Datta sir. Try to find out all the documents, make a your file, okay, maybe there are a certain document which is not available with you, get that documentation here, and because there are a specific time period for that, people will forget to submit all this documentation on time, and then it is difficult for even the official people to forward to the higher office, the concerned office, so where they are eligible candidate, so please take a benefit of all these.
एकदम फॉर्म भरताना न्यू कोर्स एनरोलमेंट केल्यानंतर तुमचा जो ओल्ड पीएनआर नंबर आहे तो न टाकायचा, न्यू कोर्स केला की सर्व फ्रेश, त्यावेळी तुमच्याकडे एलिजिबिलिटी नंबर नसेल तर नो म्हणायचा, पीआरएन नंबर नो म्हणायचा आणि फॉर्म पुढे भरायचा. होम युनिव्हर्सिटी ज्यांची आहे ज्यांची ऑर्डर होम युनिव्हर्सिटी आहे त्यांना काही प्रॉब्लेम नाही ना, आणि स्कॉलरशिप साठी डॉक्युमेंट जे तुम्ही एमसी व्हेरिफिकेशन केलेले आहेत ते डॉक्युमेंट लागणार आहे, ते इन्क्लुड ग्रॅज्युएशन मार्कशीट, टीसी, कास्ट सर्टिफिकेट, व्हॅलिडिटी, नॉन क्रिमिनल इन्कम सर्टिफिकेट, एवढे डॉक्युमेंट लागणार आहे. आणि आधार कार्डला मोबाईल नंबर लिंक पाहिजे, तरच तो तुम्ही युजर आय डी तयार करू शकता, क्रिएट न्यू युजर आय डी. ज्यांचा ऑलरेडी आधी स्कॉलरशिपचे फॉर्म भरलेले आहेत त्यांनी तो ओल्ड युजर आय डीच युज करायचा आहे, आणि तिथे ऑप्शन पण आहेत फॉरगॉट युजर आय डी, युजर नेम, पासवर्ड, आणि जरी तुम्हाला काही डाऊट आला तर तुम्ही युट्यूबला पण टाकू शकता, त्या संदर्भात भरपूर व्हिडिओ आहेत तिथे, किंवा मला कॉन्टॅक्ट केला तरी मी सांगू शकतो तुम्हाला. एक्झाम फॉर्म स्कॉलरशिप फॉर्म भरायला लास्ट डेट तशी अजून डिसाईड नाही झालेली, पण तुम्ही जेवढ्या लवकर डॉक्युमेंट असतील तर तुम्ही भरून जा, चुकून एखादा फॉर्म राहिला तर नंतर प्रॉब्लेम येतात, तर लास्ट डेटची वाट नका बघू, डॉक्युमेंट सर्व स्कॅन आहेत तुमच्याकडे तर तुम्ही भरू शकता लवकर लवकर. दहा ज्यांच्याकडे एखाद्या स्टुडंटकडे इन्कम सर्टिफिकेट अप्लाय केलं नसेल तर ते काढून ठेवा, त्या स्टुडंटनी फक्त थोड्या दिवसात भरलं तरी चालेल, पण ज्यांच्याकडे डॉक्युमेंट आहेत ते आत्ता लगेच भरू शकतात. एक्झाम फॉर्म फक्त लवकर भरा, एक्झाम फॉर्मची लास्ट डेट एक्सटेंड न होती, स्कॉलरशिप फॉर्मची डेट एक्सटेंड होती पण एक्झाम फॉर्मची अजिबात
होती.
आणि एक्झाम फॉर्म भरल्यानंतर त्याची फी अकाउंट डिपार्टमेंट मध्ये पे करायला लागेल तुम्हाला कॅश मध्ये, जर काही युनिव्हर्सिटी मध्ये ऑप्शन आला तिथे ऑनलाईन पे करा, कारण कोविड मुळे 2 वर्ष स्टुडंट डायरेक्टली युनिव्हर्सिटीला पे करत होते, जर यावेळी त्यांनी ऑफलाईन घ्या सांगितलं तर ऑफलाईन घेतलं जाईल, नाहीतर मग तुम्ही ऑनलाईन पण पे करू शकता, ते 1-2 दिवसात कळेल की ऑफलाईन का ऑनलाईन.
एनी डाऊट रिगार्डिंग द फी स्ट्रक्चर, ड्यू डेट, ऑल द सर्क्युलर, व्हेनेवर वी विल गेट द सर्क्युलर फ्रॉम द गव्हर्नमेंट, सर वी विल फॉरवर्ड टू यू. ओके, एनी अदर योर पर्सनल क्वेरी कैन कॉन्टॅक्ट.
हां, सिंगल गर्ल चाइल्ड म्हणजे घरात फक्त एकच मुलगी आहे, ती पण स्कॉलरशिप आहे सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंटची, त्याला पण तुम्ही अप्लाय करू शकता नॅशनल स्कॉलरशिप पोर्टलवर. फक्त एवढं की ज्यांनी माडीबिटीवरती अप्लाय केलाय ते एका वेळी 2 स्कीमला अप्लाय नाही करू शकत, आगेस वैकेट मध्ये ज्यांनी ऍडमिशन घेतल्यांचे सिंगल गर्ल चाइल्ड आहे ते अप्लाई करू शकतात त्या स्कॉलरशिपला.
Good afternoon, all of you. I think the both department from our faculty and Mr. Danta, one is the examination department, second is the scholarship department. Both has given the very nice information for you. Now, just beyond their information, some of the points which I want to make more clarity about these points. Immediately, I will take the first point from the scholarship. Scholarship, Danta sir has given the complete information, but as a director, I have the deadline. He thinks slightly as per the end date. The scholarship forms will require the board name Jai. Everybody has to fill up the form immediately. No date on after 10th. Whatever anybody has the problem, you can approach me otherwise Danta. But we will not allow after 10th. Why it is that? Even the deadline is 31st Jan. But we don't want to pending any subject, any issues. Once the classes is going to start from the your Monday, means again it is on the 10th, we don't want to disturb any student, anything pending. All classes will be 100% regular. I don't know what government is going to take the decision today or tomorrow. Everything will be as per the government norms. Right? So accordingly, scholarship form should be before this 10th Jan is a deadline. As per the admission process, as per you meet me personally, I know you are all documents. So I think 99% students all documents are there. Maximum student documents are there. Somebody is if their income certificate is not there, immediately you can apply for the income certificate and complete the formalities. But maximum students' income certificates are also there. Other norms, regulation already he explained about the scholarship forms. Second point about the examination forms. Examination forms. There are every year there are some difficulties, some problems are there. I request all students don't fill immediately examination forms. Even I think deadline is the 15th Jan, right? So examination forms will be filled up after 10th Jan. So don't fill anything immediately because definitely there are some issues are there. Sometimes subject issues are everything is there. If the issues will be clear from the university. But I think you fill up the form after the 10th Jan. First, give the scholarship importance immediately. We want to complete the task about the scholarship. Scholarship is very important for us. Second point, there are some central government, otherwise the national level scholarships are also there. If somebody is not eligible for the government of Maharashtra scholarship, you are the qualified, you are educated person. So you can check the all websites, any scholarship area, anywhere you can apply for the scholarship. Beyond the government also, the two governments are there, state and central government. But as per his opinion or you know that, you can't take the two scholarship benefits in simultaneously. Only you have to apply one scholarship. There are number of the scholarship from the central government also. But the cost of the benefit or the scholarship amount is more than central government in the state government of Maharashtra. So he is slightly insisting you think about the DBT means Maharashtra government. But sometimes, suppose single girl child, this scholarship only central government, national scholarship scheme. So that scholarship only this student has to apply only national scholarship. Other point about all this, our fee structure 100% students who are coming to the complete scholarship, they will get the 1,70,000 scholarship. Not a single rupee will be given from the government. Because you people are aware, we are charging as per the section should be. So there is nothing any deduction fees from the government. Entire scholarship you will get it. Other thing of the pre-seed, he used the pre-seed. Somebody may be aware, somebody may be not aware. Precinct means whatever the two, around 18,214 rupees will be not get from the precinct students. Only tuition fee, examination fee, you will get from the state government of Maharashtra. This is one thing. The next point for the university side or syllabus side, I think Mr. Gunot sir was explaining all these points. Slightly has focus about the university norms as per the university syllabus. But even though university syllabus is also available, as an institution, as a structure of the organization, as a director, as a discussion of the faculty, slightly we have to hold some of the subject or some specialization. So he used the one sentence like, you can go for the single specialization. Without miss one specialization, you will go there. But our institute will not allow to single specialization. We are compulsory offering the dual specialization. It is mandatory you do the two specializations. And don't go for the single specialization. Because here it is not a right time to explain all these things. As I am the chairman of university various authorities also, I am the coordinator of the all designing the syllabus for the University of Pune. So entire thing, now we are getting the application from the various institutions. We have not done this mistake in the last years, but we got the number of applications from the Nashik mainly. So now we want to do the dual specialization. We are not offering the dual specialization once you complete the single specialization for this reverse syllabus. So this is only the your golden opportunity to go the dual specialization. Any specialization you can go, we will not force to any student to take X or Y specialization. It is completely your decision. It is completely whatever you want to ask for your personality. Tomorrow again we are going to put the one session because related to this, your personality and career mapping. So these things are no, so many things, so many sessions or activities will be organized in this semester. So accordingly you will decide your specialization after semester one. Semester two only you have to choose your first specialization. So don't take the hurry to decide the specialization. First understand all the subject, which area is compatible. Even though you will get the knowledge from the market also, you will understand the employability, which area is good, which area is good, where my personality is fit for the specialization. So there are number of the sufficient time you have. So after that you can decide. But one thing in the first day, we will offer the dual specialization. Because of the dual specialization, there are more opportunities to get the employment also. Sometimes take the example, somebody is the business analytics, is the major specialization, minor specialization, suppose HR. So if he is getting the opportunity in business analytics, is very good. If he is eligible to apply for HR also, he will get the opportunity in HR also. So that as a point of the employability also, we make the dual specialization. And end of the day, I can say, after specialization is a just starting point, now as an MBA student, but after some experience, maybe 15 years or some more than 10 or 20 years experience, specialization doesn't matter anywhere. You have to take all specializations. You have to become the top of the organization. So then you have to study the all specialization. So after some just fresher specialization is required, getting the entry of the organization. So the specialization we will compulsory to offer the dual specialization, not a single specialization. Second thing, the subject Gunot sir has mentioned all the subject. I can say the core subject, otherwise university level subject, institute level subjects. These subjects you have to mention for the examination forms. Means you have to fill up the examination forms. These subjects 100% will be taken from the teachers. But beyond this subject, also we are going to take the some subject. That subject will be additional inputs for the student. So benefit of the placement, otherwise grooming of the students, that activity will be there. That subject may be taken from the university syllabus only. There is a basket of the subject. Out of this basket, he has selected three subjects from the university level, three subjects from the institute level. But sometimes Again, he used the one area that is fundamental subject, impeachment subject. So out of that also, we will decide the subject, which we will give the additional input. This will be the additional inputs beyond the university syllabus. The last point about these things, now we are observing the third day, today is I think third day. Accordingly, third day, we are trying to give the maximum as a general awareness, otherwise general knowledge of MBA, what is the situation in the industry, what is your goal as the purpose of the MBA. These things, the basic things are we are going to try to put on you. Right. From coming Monday, regular subject classes will be there. Again, timetable will be displayed. The faculty, I think faculties are also here. As a point of view, the first day also I told all faculty, the faculty will be also here, all the programs. Now there is not a single session is conducted for the first year. Only second year sessions are there. Second year sessions also I instructed to the HOD. He will postpone the sessions in the morning sessions and afternoon sessions, the faculty will be continuing for the afternoon sessions. But as per our groups like you, we have the second year also group. We got the information which session is there, which session is not there. Entire recording is also there. So point is here, the Vinod sir already explained the point that teachers will be explained their session plan, assessment plan means the test, current assessment, concurrent assessment test, otherwise whatever their process is there, otherwise which test they want to conduct, that will be their choice. Just as the director would decide how many tests will be taken, but which test they want to conduct, that will be the teachers are free to conduct the test. Right? But the which test they are going to conduct, what will be the schedule, everything will be announced before the starting of the sessions. Means on Monday. Monday, suppose our regular sessions will be there, subject sessions will be there. All teachers will be announced their session plan, their examination plan. Whatever test are, everything they will explain how many sessions per subject they are going to take it. Some subject as per the suppose credit of the course, we can say 3 credit, otherwise 2 credit subject. Accordingly, their session plans will be there, accordingly their number of sessions will be there. So entire plan will be there, right? So before that you will get the entire plan. So accordingly you can plan, otherwise accordingly you can give the sufficient time to your subject preparation part, right? So these things are very important. Now, some other activities within 2 days we will announce. Some of the various committees, I think you got it. Some of the messages from the faculty also, placement also. I think Dr. Anuradha, Dr. Naik also, she explained his speech that there are number of committees are there. Tomorrow, otherwise, day after tomorrow, we will announce the committee. We will make the Google form to the students. You have to show the interest in which committee you want to work. Second, again, very important committee. Our entire organization are all activities done with the leaders of the students. We are just supporters. Entire all social media, otherwise for the placement, entire students are going to lead it. So because of these all committees or the new activities yesterday, I just told in my speech that NS is also new activity. So entire activities will be done from the students. Mainly, I appreciate the students who are going to take the lead in the social media. Social media is also very important for us. One thing again I want to tell you, any activity you can recommend us. You don't have any problem about the funds. All funds, we have sufficient funds are there, they are. You just make the provision, you just request us, sir, we want to organize the cricket or sports, anything. I think number of the students in the sports area also this semester. I think I saw the 10-15 guys are especially in the sports area. So
So if they recommend, sir, we want to organize a tournament for all these schools in Pune University. We are ready. So there is nothing, any problem for the funds. We have the sufficient fund. It's like the same thing I want to tell you. How I have not accepted any installment from you? I have not given any installment facility to anybody, right? Same thing, we are ready to invest on you. We are ready to give the ROI, this return to your investment. So accordingly, you should be alert about your thing, and your maximum involvement for activities are also very important. So accordingly, we will plan it 2-3 days. And I think sessions are also going in regularly. I think as per the today, I got the very good response. Some of the 2-3 students are, they are just close to me. Close to me means I know them before the MBA, so they were meeting me to get the MBA admission. So they become like the friend. So whatever they have given the feedback in the yesterday night, I am very happy. All students are happy about the 2 days program or the resource persons or the whatever they got the knowledge from the one resource person. I think these things are very important and very most important point. Still, I have not observing from your side. Reporting timing is very important. Whenever once the teacher, otherwise coordinator or students has given the instruction on this dais, the chit chat should not be there, chatting should not be there, or that your attention should be the clear. Otherwise, somebody is looking the back and you are talking to somebody, it is going to disturb the system also. Second thing, if you want to learn, you should give the proper attention. Because these 2 years are very important in your life. So be serious about the fact all these things. And now actually I was thinking after some time, but this will be, we will give the something different plan for this academic year. How many students are going to about the 10 lakh? So was, I think Nitin sir was asking how much you are expecting, what was the outside the notice board is there. Somebody told the 8 lakh, above the 8 lakh. So according to this, not 8 lakh. You should plan to the 15 lakhs. Getting the word? So you should plan to the 12 lakhs. Where are my lakhuna? You have to find out the your lakhuna. Once your dream is there, you have to decide first dream. These 8 days are just for the making your goal or dream. First, you have to decide your dream. So this dream is very important. Your dream should be very high. You should not think low. You are the MBA students of the Madhya. Getting the point? So one thing again very important, I just want to, the senior batch is here, some few volunteers are also here. So senior batch almost in the online because of the COVID. I think only the last year again we started the induction and induction we stopped in the middle after 2 or 3 days. Same situation today also there. You know that government is again thinking similar situation was the last year also. So entire batch is in the online. So the particular inputs or particular efforts we are able to give to them online. There are some limitations. Their side and our side, both side limitations are also there. In the group, somebody was talking about the hybrid system. Otherwise, why not online classes are there? Entire process is online, you know, everything will be online, it will be also recorded, it will be on the YouTube channel. But our focus is that maximum students should be present in front of us. We will think only the 2 days of the government decision. Once the government decision is still continued, immediately every day's attendance sit in front of me. Which students are not attended last 2 days, that we know the record, we have the record. Once after the decision of the government, immediately we will start the action from our side. We will ask the results immediately. We have not given the single admission who are working in the organization. There are many students. They want to work and they want to do the complete MBA. We have whose package is about 20 lakhs also. but we have not given the admission for working. We want the full-time students. So this is the basic purpose about all this thing. And I think one point was also there. So these are the very important points. And from tomorrow again, you should attend the regular class. Some other regular activities are time is very important. And I forgot again, I have taken the point of this here. Because of the online, our top level organization meeting is there in Wadi House. Our president of this organization, again, I forgot to explain in my first introduction session. Our president is Muslim Wadiya, the president of this organization. Nes Wadiya, you people are aware, Nes Wadiya is the secretary of this organization. So when, even I also never met to the president of our organization, Muslim Wadiya, but I met the 3-4 times in this last, before COVID also, with Nes Wadiya, their organizations are also ridiculous, like the Britannia or entire Wadiya group. So the Britannia, all organizations are also from the campus. The last month also we are getting the opportunity, but see, one thing is also there, very important. They go for the IIM and all top level IITs or those organizations. We don't have any problem. If our same our B schools is there in the same organization, 100% they will visit to our organization. I think 2007-8 years back, we visited our campus. At that time, one student is shortlisted one time, and one time not a single student is shortlisted. Then they stopped for coming to the campus. I think 10-12 years back, that time I was not a director, or about some years back they was visiting. Now, there is some fear with me. If they visit to the campus for the immediately, then my students should be 100% capable to select from their group. So that preparation from the second year, because of the online sessions are taken, so we are not so much confident as a director about the second year students. But they are doing very good. But all these placements are also good. But as a Britannia, we don't want to give their chance to return to back. Renewal. So, because this offline, we will put the maximum effort for the second year also. But the first year is very important, because after immediately 1 year, they are coming for the placement. Renewal. So, these things are very important. So, we are 100% pushing to the offline courses, offline classes. We can't observe your behavioral skills. We can't observe some personality of your personality. All communication, so many things are there. We can't change and we can't assess. So because of the COVID, there is a limitation from the both side that everyone has to accept the online process. And we have to go in. So I think that COVID is that. Lastly, our career is also more important. One day COVID is 100% is going to finish. COVID will be not there. But our age, year, or today's day, suppose today is the 4th or 5th Jan. Hearing the point, 5th Jan is there. So 5th Jan will not come after 22, after the, tomorrow. Tomorrow will be only 6th Jan. So the days, periods are not going to back. So imagine this is the opportunity for you. And second, very important for your batch, because of the COVID market, we got the number of opportunity. There are employabilities, there is a ratio of the employment is very high, you know. It is highly improved. There are more of the jobs are available in the market. So this is again golden opportunity for your batch. And I just tell you again once more, your dream should be very high. Not less than 10 lakhs, everybody will think above the 10 lakhs. Because one thing is again, you know people, we have given only admission of the cutoff, is the merit, the score. And if everybody is above the 90, or suppose in against cap, suppose 80 is there,
but all is green. Originally, you are very smart. You are very strong. All qualities are there. So why not get the 15 lakhs? Definitely, you will get the 15 lakhs. But inside, I think the morning or the 2 days resource person was saying, your inside feeling should be there. So inside, you should think, I am 100% capable. Your confidence should be there. So that confidence, developing your confidence, coming to the stage, coming to the understanding. So this induction program will be there. So this once induction program is there, all regular classes will be there. And I am sure somebody, one question also somebody asked in the Vinod sir. Sir, when exam is there? The university exam. University exam generally we conduct after 90 days. After starting the semester. Semester started from the 15th November. Right? 15th November means for the mainly for the second year. Second year, 15th November, semester started. Now your semester is started as per the government 17th December. 17th December was the instruction from the government and mainly government for the DGs to start the MBA program. But 17th December was not visible from the my side because the admission is only for the first round was there. The first cap round was there. Second cap round admission was also not there. Second cap round list is announced on the 17th, but unfortunately it was announced on the 18th. So well, we have not started the classes. But few institutions in Pune, they started classes as per the government norms of the 17th only. Because they have given the admission before the cap. In their, whatever the students they have approached, maybe management quota, whatever things are there, they already given the admissions. We have not given the legal admission without the government system. So we could not start the course on the 17th January. We started course after completing the admission, all admissions. And I am sure whatever the, that 8 days or 10 days, my staff and everybody will be covered the entire syllabus. Getting the work. Entire system, morning, evening, entire system will work. Syllabus will be completed. Lastly, your results or your inputs are very important, your outputs are very important. So according to the syllabus, I think you people know, this new syllabus or revised syllabus will be given to major each and every school of the area. So I think about the syllabus, the Vinod sir has given the detail, if anything is there, we can discuss. But these things are very important, your energy should be continued. And again, tomorrow, otherwise day after tomorrow, I think day after tomorrow, the tailor is coming for the take the measurement for the your blazer. I think uniform already we have given, you have to be ready. We will announce the uniform, everything once we got the blazer date. Immediately all, I think you got the oath, your job is teaching the your uniform and be ready. Our side, the blazer and the one t-shirt is pending from our side. T-shirt and blazer we will issue as early as possible. For the taking measurement for the students, the tailor will become from the day after tomorrow. So we will schedule the same time, same schedule. So entire work will be finished, continue to go on then. And then only regular classes, guest lecture, placement activities, so many things are there. Once again, I congratulate to placement department. I think yesterday night also, how many students are placed?
Three
students are placed. So that will be the continuing process will be there. We will not post any message or any group, any placement in your group, the first year group. But I think they will conduct about the LinkedIn, your account and all these things. You can see the LinkedIn, all this. And it's sessions as per the placements are given the present starts this group. One thing in the last my sentence of the today, unfortunately I come for the visual. Be confident. You have become the
member of the Maria family. So definitely their success will be there. Your confidence, your commitment, all these things. Just you follow the instructions, rules, regulation of the institute, 100% your dream will be success. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir, for your insightful words. I announce the conclusion of today's session. However, there's an important announcement to be made. Everyone who hasn't yet communicated or had an interaction with TNP, sir, are supposed to meet right here. And reporting time for tomorrow is 9:45. There will be activities in the second half. The first half will have three speakers. And in the second half, after the post-lunch, you'll be having activities and interaction with second-year students as well. Okay, thank you. Everyone who hasn't...
Just one minute. Your second-year students should be the maximum tomorrow.
Yeah,
it is your responsibility.
Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah, the students who haven't interacted with the trainee and placement head are supposed to stay here. Others can leave. Thank you.